name is Daniel Segal. I'm a professor of biotechnology at Tel Aviv University in Israel. During the past decade or so, I have been interested in studying the molecular mechanisms that underlie neurodegenerative diseases. Using the insights from these studies, we develop small molecules to treat these diseases. In the case of Parkinson's disease, the key cause of the disease is a protein named alpha-synuclein, which exists in the cells of all of us, but in some people, for some reasons, starts to clump. These clumps are toxic. When they form in dopaminergic cells in the brain, they kill these cells. In the lab, we performed test tube experiments in which we incubated alpha-synuclein in the test tube together with a variety of small compounds and asked whether or not they are capable of inhibiting in the test tube the clumping of alpha-synuclein. One of the compounds that was most effective in inhibiting the clumping of alpha-synuclein in the test tube was mannitol. Mannitol is a small, low-calorie sugar commonly used and approved as a safe supplement for various foods for human consumption. Mannitol is also able to slightly open the blood-brain barrier, thus facilitating entrance of various medications into the brain. After the test tube experiments, we examined whether or not mannitol is effective for Parkinson also in animal models. First, we examined it in transgenic fruit flies that were engineered to have human alpha-synuclein in their brains and were shown to display Parkinson's-like symptoms. We found that feeding mannitol to these Parkinson's model flies greatly ameliorates their Parkinson's-like symptoms. For example, it improved their walking and climbing abilities. Interestingly, this was also associated with dramatic reduction in the clumps of alpha-synuclein in their brains. Next, we examined whether mannitol is also effective in Parkinson's model mice. In collaboration with Professor Eliezer Matzliach from the University of California in San Diego, we injected mannitol into the stomach of these Parkinson's model mice at an early age. Several months later, we found that the pathology of Parkinson's in their brains was significantly reduced. Specifically, we found dramatic reduction in the clumps of alpha-synuclein in their dopaminergic neurons. We published these results in 2013 in a respectable scientific journal. Several months later, I got a remarkable email from a person who is a professor of biology in a respectable university in the United States. He wrote that he had Parkinson's disease for more than 5 years and, following reading our paper, decided on his own to take mannitol. Several months later, he experienced marked improvement of some of his Parkinson's symptoms. You can imagine how excited I was. He kept reporting to me over the following year about his improvements, and when I was approached by other Parkinson's patients, I referred them to him. Over the past 2 years, some of them have written to me that they also experienced improvements of their Parkinson's symptoms. Thus, when I was approached recently by the team of CliniCrowd, who described to me their exciting initiative of developing a platform in which patients of a variety of diseases will register and report their experience using various nutrients and food supplements for their conditions. I was very happy to help them with respect to mannitol for Parkinson's disease.